Hey YouTube, what's up? It's the iPhonehelper. In this video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to change your carrier logo on iOS 4, iPod Touch, or iPhone. So as you see, I do have my carrier changed. I have a little green poison icon up there, and I'm not going to show you guys how to create a little icon, but I'm going to show you guys what to do. Okay, so you will need to know how to SSH and everything like that, like in my normal videos. So this is what you're going to do. You're going to have a folder on your desktop, and you can call this whatever you want. I just have one called Carrier. When we open up that, we'll have another folder inside that called capital U, capital I, capital I, lowercase M-A-G-E-S, just like that. Open up that, and we'll have two of our images. And these are going to be our carrier images that you want for your carrier on your iOS, iPod Touch, or iPhone. So let's just make this thumbnails. As you see, I do have my green poison images, and see how small they are. They are both the same size. They are going to be 25 by 20, both of them, 25 by 20. And what we're going to rename them, they're both going to be exactly the same images, exactly the same size. And, you know, you can just edit them in GIMP or Photoshop, whatever you might use, okay, to make them the right size. So one is going to be called black, capital B, underscore, carrier, with all capitals, underscore iPod, all capitals, and then dot png. Our other image, which will be exactly the same size, just rename it to capital S, and that will say silver, underscore carrier, all capitals, underscore iPod, all capitals, and then dot png. Now, when we have done that, all we will have to do is SSH into our device. Okay, so Windows, you will be using WinSCP, and Mac, you'll be using CyberDuck, I believe. So, there'll be a link in the description below, like always, that will take you to a video on how to do this on Windows. Let's log in, and then we can just go back once by clicking on these two dots. Okay, and we can just go down to Stash, right here, and then we can just open up Themes. Now what we'll do is, the rest of this will be easy. All we have to do is drag all the way down to the bottom, and we'll just drag our folder that we created. Mine was carrier, and we can just drag that into our little WinSCP and click copy. Now when that goes in, all you have to do is just open up Winterboard on your device and just enable it from Winterboard. It's that easy, guys. Please like this video, comment, subscribe. I'll see you guys in my next video. Catch you later.